Hello everyone, today I'm at a different location. Welcome to my parents' home. This is also where I stayed before I got married, and this house is actually almost 15 years old, and this kitchen especially, where my mom has been cooking all her amazing food, has been needing some attention for a while now. A complete renovation of this space is on my to-do list, but I thought of making a start with some basic organization to help my mom have a better space to work in. As we begin this countertop organization video, I'm just going to show you how I'm adding just some small and basic touches to put together this space and make it more appealing and functional. Honestly, this is a makeshift arrangement for now, prior to the renovation plans I have for this space later. I also want to talk about self-love and self-care today. Self-love is something that most of us tend to neglect, sometimes unconsciously. Especially us women, we get so immersed in tending to our family's needs and wants that we usually don't prioritize ourselves enough. My mom, for example, is such a beautiful soul. And you will not believe the kind of incredible food she churns out in this basic and dysfunctional kitchen without complaining at all. She has always made adjustments without demanding more. And all of us do it at some point in our lives. And the sacrifices we make as women are commendable and worth mentioning here. But if there's something that we can do in our own capacity to make our everyday lives more enjoyable, then why not? As homemakers, a lot of our time is spent in the kitchen, cooking, cleaning, etc. And sometimes it can get really mundane and feel like a burden. But just introducing some minimal, cost-effective things that are visually pleasing can make a lot of difference in how you feel during the time spent in your kitchen. Just adding some greenery, for example, is proven to have a calming effect on your mind and can contribute to a part of your self-care process. Another important aspect to this is while some of us may realize the need of self-love and care, we might be putting it off for a later date and struggling to make time for it. While some others may not even realize the importance of it. And that's where you can do your bit to pitch in. Volunteer to help be a part of someone's self-care process. Just go ahead and ask your mom, dad, husband, or wife if they need help with something. Sometimes people hesitate to ask for help even though they really need it. And if you are able to identify this, then take a step and volunteer to help even when they don't ask for it. You cannot even begin to imagine the impact that this can make in the lives of your loved ones without even realizing it. And if you are one of those people who can't ask for help, then you should definitely try asking just once. Because after all, even the Bible says, "Ask and it shall be given unto you." I have always been for any changes, even small ones, that make me feel good around the house. And that's why I decided to start with some small changes to my mum's kitchen in an attempt to contribute to a part of her self-care process. Self-love and compassion are key to mental health and well-being, and is proven to keep depression and anxiety at bay. And that's another reason I spoke about slowing down in my previous video. Slow living can actually really boost your self-care process. And by slow living, I don't mean physically slowing down, but slowing down to do things at your own pace. Sometimes your mind can be your biggest enemy when it comes to self-love. Don't believe everything you think. There is always an inner critic inside of us trying to keep us from living a full and abundant life. So always surround yourself with the people who love and encourage you. Let them remind you how amazing you are. And even if they don't tell you that, you tell yourself that, because even God thinks you are just amazing. I think I'm actually pretty happy with this basic kitchen makeover and how it's turned out, although I still think there's a lot more to be done. Please let me know in the comments below, what did you think? I hope that each one of you will definitely prioritize yourselves a little more and invest in some self-love and care. See you all soon in my next video.